Texas has a problem. And what we're doing here is one solution.
We're out here looking for feral hogs, animals that cause tons of ecological and economic damage.
And if we find them? These hogs are invasive and actually better for the environment dead than alive. So it's open hunting season all year in Texas to get rid of as many as possible.
And you can also eat them. This is wild hog, just breaded and fried.
Invasive species impact many different ecosystems all over the world. They're super destructive and hard to control. A lot of the time, there aren't many options for how to deal with them. So is what they're doing here a good solution? Should we be eating invasive species? As almost always, it was no fault of the animals that they became an issue. Pigs were brought to the United States by colonizers from Europe. Some of those pigs escaped and went feral, eventually interbreeding with Eurasian boars that were intentionally released for hunting.
So there are essentially no natural checks on this animal in the Western Hemisphere. The ecosystem is not built for it. We don't have native pigs in the Western Hemisphere.
John Tomacek is a wildlife biologist at A&M University in Texas.
And so now we're living in the reality of this animal.
This hybrid has the characteristics of a wild animal, but as many offspring as domestic pigs. That's one of the reasons that feral hogs have spread so much in the United States. Sometimes they are also transported to create hunting opportunities, leading to the establishment of new populations. And as more land is used for crop production, the hogs get more opportunities for easy food and shelter. It's estimated that there are at least 6 million animals in the U.S. Nearly half are in Texas. And they cause a lot of problems.
We know that every year there's in excess of $500 million of damage done by pigs, or feral hogs, excuse me.
And that's mostly to agriculture and property. It doesn't even include environmental damage. For comparison, all tornadoes in the U.S. in 2022 cost around $700 million. One way the hogs cause problems is by foraging for food. With native animals, it can be beneficial, but it can also cause damage, especially in areas where soils are fragile or dry. They also prefer to eat native species, chomping through oak, pecan, hickory, and walnut trees, as well as birds and sea turtles. And because pigs can't effectively sweat, they gather around water sources, contaminating them with feces. These piggies are also tough. They have incredibly sharp tusks and hard skin on their shoulders that makes them difficult to kill. In Texas, they have no predators. But invasive species aren't only a problem in Texas or in the United States. Wild boar are causing an uproar in Italy. Lionfish have invaded the Caribbean and the Mediterranean. Norway's waters are full of red king crabs. And Canada is plagued by Chinese mystery snails. The list goes on and on.
They have a species that is able to reproduce very fast, tolerates different temperatures, and sometimes they are better at acquiring resources, say food or refugees.
Morelia Camacho Cervantes is a biologist and the director of the Invasive Species Lab at her university.
Catastrophically, we could end with a population that is huge of a species that has never been there, and it's the only thing you find there.
Like with these lionfish, they eat other fish and crustaceans, have painful poisonous spines, and can lay thousands of eggs every few days. By outcompeting or eating everything else, they can destroy whole ecosystems. It's not their fault, but like the hogs, they don't belong and they're destroying the environment.
I'm not mad at these animals. I'm really not. But I don't have a choice in terms of conservation. They have to go and our options are fairly limited.
And one of those limited options is hunting.
This ranch about an hour outside of Austin has tons of feral hogs running around on it. And the owner is happy for people to come out here and kill them.
We met with a hunter to see what it was all about.
Amanda.
Jeff, nice good to see you, Amanda.
The hogs are nocturnal, so we had to wait until it was dark to try and find some. In the meantime, we went to go fill up feeders used to attract animals.
How do you know where the hogs are?
We typically have game cameras on those feeders that we can basically see what's been coming into that feeder and about what time, and that can give us some clue. If you see something that came in yesterday, there's a lot better chance they'll come in today than if they didn't come in yesterday, but it's never a guarantee. It's less than 50-50.
pretty smart then.
Yeah.
If they see some hunters, then they won't come back the next day to that same area, or?
If a hunter took a shot at a pig yesterday, there's virtually no chance that pig will come anywhere close for a long time.
Even though they're everywhere, it can be really hard to catch them.
Did you say pig pipe?
We call it a pig pipe.
Which naturally requires some target practice.
You shoot using your right eye?
Yes.
Not missing it by much.
Boom, there you go.
When it got late enough, we loaded up the gun and drove to where the hogs had been yesterday and waited. And waited. And waited. In the end, we only saw a couple of turkeys and left. But when we checked the cameras later, we were outsmarted. This is a serious downside to hunting individual animals. It's not super effective. The hogs obviously knew we were there and avoided the area until we were gone. But I was a bit relieved. The idea of killing an animal, especially such a smart one, did make me nervous. And I'm not the only one.
The closer species are to us, the more difficult it is to eradicate them. Once they have arrived where they don't belong, you would have to eradicate them pretty quickly. And by eradicating, I do mean killing.
This is the case with all invasive species. Relocating them doesn't work because they will just cause a problem somewhere else. They can also be trapped or poisoned. People in Texas also enjoy shooting them from helicopters with machine guns. But while that seems ridiculous, it's what experts do, because the whole group of hogs is killed, so can't teach others how to avoid humans. If carcasses are heavily diseased, they're landfilled, but otherwise they're left for other animals to eat, gone within a few days. Even so, mass shooting animals and leaving them seems like a waste. So some people get creative.
Hey.
Hey.
Amanda.
Jesse.
Nice to meet you.
So nice to meet you.
Going inside?
Yeah.
Because where you find edible invasive species...
Wow. Let me get out of the way here.
You also find people who are eating them.
So this is a hog that they got in this morning, and he's about to break it down. So how did you come up with the idea to serve wild boar in your restaurant?
They're delicious, they're underutilized, they need to be controlled. You have to kill something like 70% of them every year to keep the population where it is, which is not gonna happen. If we don't do something with them, we're gonna just have a far worse problem. It's kind of an inarguable source of protein. Like every pound of feral hog that we're able to serve is also one less pound that's coming out of kind of a broken industrial meat system. So this is the cut that I want you to try.
Do you use everything?
Yeah, off of this carcass, everything will be used. The bones will go into stock. A lot of it will go into stuff like sausage.
I spoke to somebody from A&M who said that they need to basically go out and shoot a bunch of them all the time. How do you kind of feel about that situation?
My role, our role, is what do we do with the dead pigs? Other people's role is making them dead. You know, like A&M, they're approaching it. They're not thinking like, oh, can we make chorizo out of that? Or is it a nice acorn-fed one that we're gonna get chops? They're thinking, oh, it's the sounder came in last night and devastated this farmer's fields. We need to eradicate that species at all costs.
I haven't eaten pork in over a decade for environmental reasons, but decided to try this one.
Just take this mallet and pretty gently, you don't want to like use it, not like a hammer.
This is much harder than it seems.
You know, if it came down to just one meat that I was forced to say is like the best one for us to consume, I wouldn't even pause. It's this one, you know, right here.
Oh, it's really good. It's awesome, yeah.
Yeah.
It's really good.
Yeah.
Okay, I can definitely see why you'd serve it in your restaurant.
Yeah, right.
In Mexico, invasive lionfish also end up on plates.
Locals started fishing them with the purpose of consuming it. And then they were very creative with the recipes they were making, and they were selling a lot, so they were fishing a lot. And now they have populations that are very small.
Eating them doesn't just solve what to do with the dead animals. It also provides an incentive for people to kill them. Without it, people need to be convinced.
We have to think about preserving what we already have out there, which is already pretty threatened. It is difficult for a lot of people to understand.
There isn't much of a choice when it comes to getting rid of invasive species. And while hunting them for food isn't the most effective solution, it is a palatable one. And if the protein can replace industrial meat, it's doubly sustainable. In the end, it's humans' fault these species are there in the first place, but that doesn't make killing them any easier. I, for one, am happy I didn't have to do it, but also that someone out there is.
So should we be eating invasive species? Let us know what you think and subscribe for new videos every Friday.